Hi, Jefferson Santos here, seven-figure entrepreneur and author of the book, Higher Life Design. And today, I want to talk about always being right. You know, there's a quote by Stephen Johnson that says, being right keeps you in the same place, while being wrong forces you to explore. And so, being right really doesn't cause us to really grow. I mean, think about how many times that we wanted to be right. I mean, we've all heard the opposition quote of, do you want to be right or do you want to be rich? You know, do you want to be right or do you want to be happy? Right? And think about that for a second, because there's a lot of times in our relationships, right, and also in business, that we want to be right and we're hammering it that we want our opinion and because we're right, and then that kind of steals our joy. And then really, we don't really grow from that. And so once again, being wrong is also a way that you can grow. I know it doesn't feel good, but it's a way that we can grow. And so I want you to think about, how is that serving you in your relationships right now? Now, when I say relationships, I mean also with your kids, if you have kids, spouse or significant other, and or your coworkers, or maybe even your boss. How is that working for you right now? For me, it didn't work that well. And maybe if you are right, you don't need to tell them that you're right. You might say, hey, listen, in my experience, here's what I've encountered. And then you share your opinion versus saying, well, you know, this is the way it is and blah, 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 blah. You know, and so I think there's ways that you can kind of assert your professionalism of, you probably know the right answer, but you don't need to come off as if you're the know-it-all. Because once again, there still needs to be room for learning. Because once again, when you're wrong, there's that room to explore. It's like, okay, well, there's been times, obviously several times in my life, a lot, where I feel that I'm right. Like, I feel it's the best answer in the world, but I didn't even say the answer. Somebody said something else, and that was a better answer than mine. And I asked them, well, why did you say that? And they explained it to me. It's like, whoa, I learned a whole new way of looking at something. And because I was myopic and I was in my own little world with my opinions and what I think I know and what I've experienced and all this stuff, I thought I had the right answer. And think about that for a second. The more we think we're right all the time, the less we're gonna grow. So, I mean, it reminds me of, you know, the late Steve Jobs. You know, he was right about the Macintosh. He was right about a lot of different things, but he was butting up against his own company and they fired him from his own company that he started. But because he was fired and it was a humbling experience, he was forced to kind of reinvent himself. He learned a lot from that. And he developed Next, which developed technologies like the OS X and then the stuff that's on the iPhone and then all the other softwares that, you know, Apple and iPhone and all that is today, you know, and then Pixar. And then he became, you know, the largest shareholder in Disney. And all of a sudden, you know, he got so big, it was like Apple needed him back. And so, Apple wouldn't be what it is today if he wouldn't have got fired. And so, once again, he learned from that. And because he was big enough to learn from that, he turned that into something great. And so, hopefully, just that little nugget right there, I mean, it's helped me tremendously in my life and in my relationships and my business. And so, hopefully, that nugget right now helps you as well. And in my next video, I look forward to helping you arrive at your intended destination healthy, wealthy, and happy.